Hello, I'm Karuno from Physiology Department, School of Medical Sciences, Industry Science Measure. In this video, we are going to talk about oxygen transport in blood. In blood, oxygen is carried in two forms, dissolved and bound to hemoglobin. Dissolved oxygen accounts for only 2% of the total oxygen content in the blood. Because dissolved oxygen is free, meaning it does not bind to anything, this dissolved oxygen exerts partial pressure in the blood. On the other hand, the remaining 98% of the total oxygen content of blood is bound to hemoglobin. Because this type of oxygen bound to hemoglobin, it does not exert any partial pressure. So this keeps partial pressure of oxygen in the arterial blood lower than in the alveolar. So this allows oxygen to always diffuse from alveolar into the blood. Although dissolved oxygen is important, oxygen bound to hemoglobin is even more important to meet the tissue's demand for oxygen. Dissolved oxygen is not enough to meet tissue's demand. According to Henry's law, the concentration of a dissolved gas is proportional to its partial pressure times its solubility constant. So the concentration of oxygen in the blood is equal to its partial pressure in the arteries, which is 100 mm mercury, times oxygen solubility constant in the blood, which is 0.003 ml per 100 ml of blood per millimeter mercury. So there is about 0.3 ml of oxygen per 100 ml blood. At this concentration, dissolved oxygen is not enough to meet tissue's demand. For example, when a person is resting, oxygen consumption or oxygen needed for basic tissue metabolism is about 250 ml per minute. If oxygen delivery to the tissues is only in dissolved form, then the oxygen delivery will be equal to cardiac output times concentration of dissolved oxygen in 100 ml of blood, and the total would be 15 ml per minute, which is not enough compared to 250 ml per minute that is needed. So because of that, oxygen bound to hemoglobin is really important for oxygen delivery to the tissues. Hemoglobin is a globular protein consisting of four subunits. Each subunit contains a hemoiety, which is an iron-binding porphyrin, and a polypeptide chain, which is designated either alpha or beta. Adult hemoglobin has two alpha chains and two beta chains. Each subunit can bind one molecule of oxygen, so one molecule of hemoglobin can hold four molecules of oxygen. When four molecules of oxygen bound to hemoglobin, the hemoglobin is said to be 100% saturated. When only three oxygen molecules are bound to a hemoglobin, it is said to be 75% saturated. And when two oxygen are bounded, it is 50% saturated. When hemoglobin is deoxygenated, or it does not bound any oxygen molecules, it is called deoxyhemoglobin. When hemoglobin is oxygenated, it is called oxyhemoglobin. This loading and unloading of oxygen to hemoglobin is a reversible process. There are other types of hemoglobin such as methemoglobin, fetal hemoglobin, and hemoglobin S. In normal hemoglobin, iron in the hemoieties must be in the ferrous state to be able to bind with oxygen. In methemoglobin, the iron component is in the ferric state. So methemoglobin does not bind oxygen. Methemoglobin can be caused by oxidation, by nitrites or sulfonamides, or it can be congenital, whereby there is deficiency of methemoglobin reductase. In fetal hemoglobin, the two beta chains are replaced by two gamma chains. Because of this, fetal hemoglobin has a higher affinity for oxygen compared to adult hemoglobin. So this makes the oxygen movement from the mother to the fetus easier. Fetal hemoglobin is slowly replaced by adult hemoglobin within the first year of life. Hemoglobin S is an abnormal hemoglobin that causes sickle cell disease. In hemoglobin S, the alpha chains are normal, but the beta chains are not. The deoxygenated hemoglobin S has an abnormal sickle shape, which can cause occlusion of small blood vessels. Hemoglobin S has lower affinity for oxygen compared to adult hemoglobin. The most important factor determining the percentage of hemoglobin saturation with oxygen is the partial pressure of oxygen in the blood. Oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve shows the binding of oxygen to hemoglobin at different partial pressure of oxygen. The x-axis is the partial pressure of oxygen from 0 to 100 mm mercury. The y-axis is the saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen, also from 0 to 100%. When partial pressure of oxygen increases in the pulmonary capillaries, the percentage of hemoglobin saturation is also increased. However, the curve is not a straight curve, it is sigmoidal. This is because of positive cooperativity. Hemoglobin is tetrameric. Four oxygen molecules can bind. The binding of the first molecule of oxygen increases the affinity for the second oxygen molecule. Binding of the second oxygen molecule increases the affinity for the third oxygen molecule, and the binding of the third increases the affinity for the fourth. So this is positive cooperativity. Each oxygen molecule attached to hemoglobin increases hemoglobin affinity to the next oxygen molecule. In comparison with myoglobin, which is monomeric, binding to only one oxygen molecule, there is no positive cooperativity. Because of this, the curve for myoglobin is not sigmoidal. A significant point on the oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is the P50. P50 is the partial pressure of oxygen when hemoglobin is 50% saturated. In this graph, when hemoglobin is 50% saturated with oxygen, the partial pressure of oxygen is 25 mm mercury. So the P50 is 25 mm mercury. The change in P50 value can determine the change of hemoglobin affinity for oxygen. When P50 value increase, the affinity decrease. And when P50 value decrease, the affinity increase. When the P50 value increase, the curve is said to shift to the right. Hemoglobin affinity for oxygen decrease. So higher partial pressure of oxygen is needed for 50% saturation. Conversely, when the P50 value decrease, the curve is said to shift to the left. Hemoglobin affinity increase. So lower partial pressure of oxygen is needed for 50% saturation. We will take a look at factors that may cause this right or left shift shortly. The sigmoidal shape of the oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve explains why in the alveolar, oxygen is loaded into the pulmonary capillary blood, while in the tissues, oxygen is unloaded from the systemic capillaries into the tissues. In the lungs, arterial pressure of oxygen is 100 mm mercury. At 100 mm mercury, hemoglobin is 100% saturated. Due to positive cooperativity, affinity is highest. Because of the high affinity, oxygen will tend to be loaded from the alveolar onto the hemoglobin. The plateau portion of the curve, which is the oxygen partial pressure between 60 to 100, provides a margin of safety in oxygen carrying capacity of blood, which means human can tolerate sudden decrease in alveolar PO2 to as low as 60 mm mercury without compromising the amount of oxygen carries by hemoglobin. For example, in the case of decrease in atmospheric pressure, hemoglobin will still be nearly 100% saturated and has high affinity for oxygen. In the tissues, venous pressure of oxygen is about 40 mm mercury. So at PO2 of 40, hemoglobin is only 75% saturated. So the affinity for oxygen is decreased compared when it is in the lungs. So the lower affinity makes it easier for oxygen to be unloaded or released to the tissues. The steep portion of the curve, which is between 0 to 60 mm mercury, also provide a margin of safety where if partial pressure of oxygen decreases, oxygen can be quickly released to the tissues. For example, when tissue activity increases, for example during exercise, PO2 may drop to 20 mm mercury. So because of this, large amount of oxygen are released to the tissues. The oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve can shift to the right or to the left. When the graph is shifted to the right, the P50 value increases, meaning 50% hemoglobin saturation is achieved at a higher than normal value of PO2. Normally, the P50 value is around 25 mm mercury. When the curve is shifted to the right, the P50 value is more than 25 mm mercury. So this means that the hemoglobin affinity for oxygen is decreased. When the affinity is decreased, the unloading of oxygen is easier. One of the factors that can cause the curve to shift to the right is increase in partial pressure of carbon dioxide as well as decrease in pH. When metabolic activity of the tissues increase, the production of carbon dioxide increases. Carbon dioxide is converted to carbonic acid, and carbonic acid is dissociated into hydrogen and bicarbonate ions. Increase in hydrogen ions means decrease in pH. Increase in PCO2 and low pH will decrease the affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. Shift the curve to the right and increase the P50. All of this will make oxygen unloading from hemoglobin to the tissues easier. So this will help to meet tissues demand for oxygen. The effect of PCO2 and pH on the oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is called Bohr effect. Another factor that can shift the curve to the right is increase in temperature. For example, during exercise, there is increase in the temperature because of the heat produced by the working muscle. The high temperature shifts the curve to the right, increase the P50, decrease hemoglobin affinity for oxygen, and makes oxygen unloading to the tissues easier. The working muscle will also produce lactic acid, which will cause reduction in pH. This will also promote the shifting of the curve to the right. Increase in 2,3-BPG will also shift the curve to the right. 2,3-biphosphoglycerate or diphosphoglycerate is a byproduct of glycolysis in red blood cell. 2,3-BPG binds to the beta chains of deoxyhemoglobin and reduces their affinity for oxygen. This decrease in affinity causes the curve to shift to the right, which makes unloading of oxygen to the tissues easier. Increase in 2,3-BPG can be observed during hypoxemia or at high altitude. For example, living at a high altitude causes hypoxemia, which stimulates the production of 2,3-BPG in red blood cell. As an adaptive mechanism, the increased level of 2,3-BPG facilitates oxygen delivery to the tissues, so this meets the demand of the tissues for oxygen. So there are primarily four factors that can shift the curve to the right: high PCO2, low pH, high temperature, and high 2,3-BPG. The factors that shift the curve to the left is the opposite: low PCO2, high pH, low temperature, and low 2-3 BPG. When the curve is shifted to the left, the P50 value decreases, meaning 50% hemoglobin saturation is achieved at a lower than normal value of PO2. Hemoglobin has higher affinity for oxygen, so this causes the unloading of oxygen to the tissues is more difficult. The effect of decrease in PCO2 and increase in pH is again the Bohr effect. When there is a decrease in tissue metabolism, there is decrease in CO2 production, so hydrogen ion concentration is also decreased, so pH increase. So when the demand for oxygen decreases, oxygen is more tightly bound to hemoglobin and less oxygen is unloaded to the tissues. Also, when tissue metabolism decreases, less heat is produced, so the low temperature will shift the curve to the left. The concentration of 2-3 BPG will also decrease with decreased tissue metabolism, which will shift the curve to the left. Another factor that can shift the curve to the left is fetal hemoglobin. As we learned earlier, fetal hemoglobin has gamma chains instead of beta chains. 2-3 BPG binds to the beta chains and does not bind that heavily to the gamma chains. So, when less 2-3 BPG is bound to the hemoglobin, affinity for oxygen increases. So, fetal hemoglobin has higher affinity for oxygen than adult hemoglobin. Because arterial pressure of oxygen in the fetus is low, about 40 mm mercury, so this increased affinity is beneficial to the fetus. In this video, we have learned that oxygen is transported in two forms, dissolved and bound to hemoglobin. Oxygen bound to hemoglobin is important to meet tissues' demand for oxygen. Hemoglobin has four chain subunits. When all four chains are occupied with oxygen, it is 100% saturated. Hemoglobin saturation is determined by the partial pressure of oxygen. Oxygen-hemoglobin dissociation curve shows the binding of oxygen to hemoglobin at different partial pressure of oxygen. It is a sigmoidal curve because each binding of oxygen molecule will increase hemoglobin's affinity for another molecule. The curve can shift to the right or left for several factors. When the curve is shifted to the right, the P50 increases, hemoglobin affinity for oxygen decreases, more oxygen is released to the tissues. This can be caused by high PCO2, low pH, high temperature, or high 2-3 BPG. Hypoxemia or high altitude will also shift the curve to the right. When the curve is shifted to the left, P50 decrease, hemoglobin affinity for oxygen increase, less oxygen is released to the tissues. So the curve is shifted to the left when there is low PCO2, high pH, low temperature and low 2-3 BPG, as well as in fetal hemoglobin. So that's all for oxygen transport. Thank you for watching.